Okay, everybody, and welcome back to Learn with Minecraft Education. And we're starting to get into some of the slightly more in-depth features of the software now. So please do subscribe and like this video and go back and look through some of our previous videos if you think there's something you might have missed. Now, in today's episode, we're going to be looking at exporting worlds. Obviously, you'll want to be doing this with a view to sending worlds to your students for them to explore and to create, and for them to send back to you if they've changed anything or if they've created something they want you to take a look at. Okay, so let's go ahead, click play, and let's go to view my world. So let's assume that we've made a world like this one here, my maze, that we may want students to visit and try out. And in a previous video, we did look at creating a maze and having questions and navigating through the maze. So this might be something that we might want to use. So if I click on my maze, what I can do is go to settings, and I can go right to the bottom here. I can export this world. All right, so it's going to create a file that I can send out to my students. But first, we need to go through some of the different modes here that we're going to want, because when we were last playing this world, usually would be in creative mode. Okay, so we can get them to, we can export this world with creative mode being the default, and we can have all of these normal settings that we use as an operator and so on, and all these kind of things. We can use code builder, we can change to world builder mode and so on. But actually, usually we want to kind of preserve the world that we've created. So for a maze, for example, we wouldn't want the user to be able to destroy the blocks and just make their way to the end of the maze by knocking down all the walls and so on. So in survival mode, that's a problem because we don't want the people getting attacked or anything like that. So what we usually look for is adventure mode and difficulty peaceful. So in adventure mode, the students that go into the world, the users, they can't really interact with a lot of the elements of the world that you don't want them to. So particularly digging down, flying around into the air and knocking down blocks or building new blocks, all of those things are going to be out of bounds. There's a very few things they can interact with, like NCPs and I think there's grass and stuff like that that they can harvest. But apart from that, the world is pretty much unchangeable. It's locked for them. So in an example like this, when they're moving around the maze, if they try and knock down a wall, if they feel frustrated or they're trapped in the maze, they're just not going to be able to do that, all right? So that's usually the one that you're going to want, adventure. Show coordinates can sometimes be useful, particularly if you've got teacher mode activated. If you're working together, you can see their coordinates and get them moving around. But we'll come to teacher mode on another video. Activate cheat, code builder, always day. Again, if you want those on, you can toggle them on, and if not, you can toggle them off. And then export world. Okay, so when we click this, we can save this as my maze, and it's going to come up on desktop. Just click save. There we go. Level export finished successfully. Now, I'm just going to go into a few reasons why we might want to export our worlds this way, just to back them up. Because if we go to our worlds, notice that every time you exit Minecraft, it automatically saves and exits. Okay, so these are going to be constantly backed up. But if someone else goes into one of these worlds and knocks something down or anything like that, it's kind of changed then. And the only way to go back to it is if you've exported it and saved it somewhere else in the state that you wanted it. Okay, so when students start sending work back to you, if you haven't put it in adventure mode and they've messed around with the world that you've created, you're going to need to go back to this version that you've exported to then send it out again to other students. All right, so if you have created a world, a lesson, rather than just having it saved in here in my worlds, do back it up, go to export, save it somewhere on your desktop or somewhere in your file system that you can get to it another time, because you might lose some of your work or have something done to your world that you don't want. Okay. Now, in a future episode, we're going to be looking at coding our agents, which is the next section in these lessons. So do stay tuned and subscribe to the channel so that you're notified when that comes out. Thanks for tuning in.